Hello students, welcome to the class. In our previous lecture we have gone through about the different parts, different structures of the flower. Now let us see about its reproductive parts. So let us start. See, the main reproductive part of a flower is called as androecium and the female one is called as gynoecium or the carpel. So let us see the first part, androecium, which is the main reproductive part. This is a typical anther structure. I had told you that anther is having a part which is the bilobed called anther and a filament, right? And this together makes the male reproductive part or the male reproductive organ, which you can see over here, and they are called as the stamen, right? So this stamen is a structure. Let us see this. This is the dorsal view of it. This is the structure. Actually, when you will see the anther under the microscope, you will see that it is distinguished into two different parts, two different sections. That is called as the lobe. So here it has been mentioned that anther lobes. One lobe of it is this and the other lobe, other section is this one. In between you can see this area. This is the actually connective tissue of both of these lobes. So this is joining these two lobes over here. So this is the connective part. This long stalk which you can see, this is the filament. Further, when you will dissect it or when you will cut it, then this kind of a structure you will be seeing, and this is called as TS of anther. When you will cut it from here, you will see that each lobe, for example, if this lobe is here, this lobe is having two sacs inside that. So each lobe is having two sacs. So now this is the one lobe and this is the second lobe. This is having two sacs and this one is having two sacs. Inside these pollen sacs, there are a number of pollens present inside. Now each of the pollen is having ability to fertilize. It just depends on the quality of this pollen. Now when, if you will see, if you will just take this one pollen comes out, when it will land over here on the stigma, and if a stigma accepts it, then it will be able to fertilize, right? So this is the structure of the main reproductive part of a flower. Anther, which is bilobed and powdery substance it is having, that is called the pollen inside that. This is the yellowish color. This is a connective tissue in between which joins these two lobes. It is attached with the filament. When you will cut this lobe, you will see that each lobe is having two, just one pair of sac, that is total four pollen sacs are there and two lobes in it. Further, coming to the female's reproductive part, which you can see over here, stigma, style and ovary collectively called as the pistil. And if you will talk about all the female's reproductive part, it is called as the carpel. This is the place called stigma. On stigma, pollen lands. Suppose this is the pollen, if it will come and land over here, then stigma is going to identify that whether this particular pollen is of good quality or not, whether it is of its own species, same kind or not. If it will be won't, then this is going to kick it off, it will be thrown away, it won't be accepted by the stigma. But if it is of a good quality and of the same species, same type, then it is going to accept it. Further, this pollen will come over here and it will release the male gamete from inside, and further that male gamete is going to come from here through style, it will come to the ovary. Inside the ovary, this part is ovule. So inside the ovary, many number of ovules are there. So inside the ovule, it will come and then through the micropyle end, it will reach inside this, and here it will do the fertilization, where the haploid, that is the N pollen, and haploid which is N, ava will be released, and when these two are going to get joined, they will make 2N zygote, which will result to the next embryo. So this is the structure of male and female reproductive parts of a flower. So further later on we'll see about the fertilization, that how does it happens in the flowering plant.